intervene, to use our good relations with the Russians in order to persuade them to stop this action is entirely understandable. There are some very important principles at stake here. The fact is that India has consistently upheld these principles: the inviolability of sovereign borders, the inadmissibility of change through force and violence, that countries are not supposed to go and achieve their objectives by invading other countries. That's why diplomacy was invented. The importance of establishing the principle that no country has a right to conduct regime change in another country. We have upheld these principles consistently when it came to others wanting to attack Libya, Syria, Iraq, and so on. Our stand has been that we do not support invading other countries, we do not support resolving problems by violence and war, and we do not support regime change. Now, Russia is a friend, and there may be some sympathy for their legitimate security concerns on their immediate borders. But for us to suddenly go silent on these crucial principles is undoubtedly going to be seen as a disappointment by Ukraine and by the friends of Ukraine. In many cases, it will be seen even as a betrayal of principles that are in India's interest to maintain, because our principles, these principles are principles that apply to all countries in all situations everywhere. And it's a pity that India has chosen to go silent on these principles. Well, I think we have carefully chosen not to blame anyone, and we have carefully chosen to say nothing about either an invasion or an attack, or to point any fingers at Russia. De-escalation implies there are two sides fighting and you want them both to calm down. But in this case, that is not the reality. The reality is one side has attacked another, has sent troops from one country to another. This is not the situation where we can truly just request both sides to de-escalate. We have to ask the Russians to stop what they're doing. We have to remind the Russians that they're violating principles that matter to us. You know, when we have friendships where we are unable to speak honestly and frankly to our friends, then the friendship isn't really worth all that much. It's not particularly, to my mind, admirable when a country like India, which has been proud for many years of taking a principled stand on international issues, a country which has even been talked about as a potential permanent member of the Security Council, for us to go silent on these internationally recognized principles does not reflect well on us at all. Indians are mainly students in Ukraine, and of those, in fact, about 2,300 are from Kerala. I too have received a number of messages from families pleading that I should intervene with the ministry. I know the ministry is already aware of the problem, so I'm not blaming them. But the only thing that can be said is that perhaps the time to do this would have been sooner. Today the airspace was closed because of the military actions ongoing. And with the airspace closed, there is no practical way of bringing people back. There is no way you can get them out of Ukraine into a neighboring country to fly here, and there are certainly no flights going in right now into Ukraine itself. For this reason, I think we have to be prepared to look after them in Ukraine until such time as there is a ceasefire or circumstances permit aircraft to go in, or if there is a humanitarian pause where both sides agree that foreign flights can come in and pull people out. And India should be prepared for all of those options. There are sometimes situations where even in the middle of a war, both sides will agree in a particular window where foreigners can be evacuated and they will not interfere, they will not shoot these planes and so on. Right now, that's not the situation. It's still very fluid, very active. And in those circumstances, the best our embassy can do is to reach out to and be available to the Indian students who are quite desperate. Many of you have seen on social media videos of students demonstrating outside the Indian embassy, some students complaining that no one is answering their phones and so on. I mean, the embassy must be overwhelmed with the demands, and so I'm not blaming anyone, but I think it's important that they give help. Some of the students have left their university campuses where the facilities aren't good enough and come to other towns. They may need to be accommodated. Some students definitely should stay where they are if they can be safe or if they're beyond any targetable area. And wherever people don't have the resources to look after themselves, don't have the money and so on, the embassy should help. One of the things that I think we should also reassure, particularly our poorer students, is that when evacuation time comes, that whether you have money or not will not be a factor. India will take responsibility to bring its citizens back. The first plane absolutely no doubt that Russia is in violation of every principle of international law, as well as the established processes, the so-called Minsk Agreement and the Normandy process that was being followed to discuss its differences with Ukraine. Russia has legitimate security concerns. No one is saying they should not legitimately say that NATO should not expand to their doorstep and that there should be some arguments in favor of respecting their own space and their own security. But for Russia to go in and attack another country while proclaiming a desire to change the regime in that country and at the same time to violate borders with impunity, all of these are not legitimate, these are illegitimate actions. And I would say that it is in no one's interest to condone such behavior, because when something wrong like this happens, it is wrong for others too. And one day, if the Chinese march into our country, we want others to stand up for us. And similarly, while the Ukrainians are turning to us and saying, please help us, please try and talk to the Russians to stop. We may not succeed, the Russians may be determined to do, but at least we should try. We should stand up and be counted on the right side on this issue.